Activities in the memory of the late Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, started with special prayers, which were held at Parliament. It's at this occasion that the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, revealed her last words with Olanya while on his hospital bed in Seattle in USA.
Among, in me, I am telling you to come. You're refusing to come. You will come and get bones. That's when I said, I called Chairman Mao, called CJ, called Jane Achen, and said, we must go.
Among assured the family of the late that they will receive all entitlements that they were meant to get. She noted that the Parliamentary Pensions Act was intentionally amended to remove obstacles that were making it difficult for Lanya's family to receive adequate retirement benefits.
Jacob is one person who believed in humanity. And we have said as Parliament of Uganda, the principle of Ubuntu must continue. We will work for the people, we will work for humanity. We are people's servants. We are here to serve the people of Uganda and serve humanity wherever they are.
Among also divulged that she was never interested in running for speakership to replace Olanya because she saw it as betrayal. But she was only persuaded by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, the Chief Justice, Alphonse Owinyidolo, and some other MPs.
When Honorable Tayewa came in as a Deputy Speaker, he came to me and said, you stand for a speakership. I said, I can't. I will be breaking the promise I made with Jacob. He shed tears before me. He said, please do.
Among also revealed that Olanya's sickness, which later claimed his life, started one day after his swearing in as a speaker of the 10th Parliament.
We were sworn in today. Jacob fell sick that the next day. I was thrown in the ocean. You don't know how to swim. In the middle of the ocean. Remember, in the 10th Parliament, if there is a person who used not to attend the sessions, it was me.
In the afternoon, Parliament held a special sitting to commemorate the first anniversary of the passing of the late Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya. The Deputy Speaker, Thomas Tayewa, committed that the current leadership of the House will continue working in the footsteps of her predecessor, Jacob Olanya, who believed in evidence-based legislation.
You can reach a compromise by hiding the truth. No, you say the truth, confront it, and then come to a middle point. So that was very, very important aspect of his, and I'm glad many of you colleagues have been able to bring out issues in a truthful manner, not trying to hide them. And if we carry on this even to our constituencies.
The motion was moved by the government chief whip, Dennis Hamson Oboa, and seconded by the Kalungu West MP, Joseph Sewungu, on behalf of the opposition. Legislators hailed Olanya as a very great debater whose deliberations could move the House to the direction he wanted. The Kiramu Municipality MP, Ibrahim Semuju Nganda, beseeched leadership of Parliament to allocate more time to MPs who make enough research on topics.
Late Jacob Olanya was a very good debater, and he also did a lot of research.
Legislators remembered the former speaker as a leader who always methodically guided on matters of adequate legislation and always made time for MPs to listen to their concerns. Many described Olanya as their mentor, a peacemaker, a patriot, and a man of integrity whose input they will dearly miss.
Right Honorable Speaker, Jacob Olanya, as the Ugandan promise or the Ugandan hope, when he assented to the office of the Speaker, there were a lot of expectations from Ugandans.
Something which I learned from him, that he worked for the unity of this house. Even our colleagues who were on the other side, he accommodated them, he treated them as one team.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.